Yasser Zaghloul is my friend. I met him once in my life, but he is in my heart. He's a pioneer in the pain management and...
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Professor Assam. And it is my pride to share today in the Professor Ansari. Actually, I teach him a lot of things. I follow him almost every week. And I hope he can listen to my lectures and give me his comment. Anyway, we are going to talk about some anesthesia in 1922. And of course, you will ask, how is the world during this time? First use of insulin in Canada, in Toronto. Actually, it used in young girl. They give her this insulin and some improvement of her diabetes. But the first commercial available insulin was in 1923, so after 1 year. And you can see this, the clothes of the woman in 1922, very elegant and very nice style. And actually, it is very cheap as well. You can see the whole coat is $6 only, and the cap with the rest is for $13 only, and very nice shoes as well. In 1922, Ireland started to be free, and it was completed in 1923. Actually, this is after occupation by Great Britain for more than 100 years. But they did a lot of job to be free after this 100 years of occupation. Regarding the anesthesia, you can see in anesthesia in 1922, graduation of the anesthesia nurse from John Hopkins Hospital for the School of Anesthesia of Nurses. So the progress of anesthesia was not so bad during this time that to qualify some nurses to help the physician during anesthesia. And one of the landmarks of the regional anesthesia by Gaston Lapate from Mayo Clinic. And he published his book about the regional anesthesia technique and the clinical applications. And this book actually stayed for more than 20 years the main source for regional anesthesia. And the next year after that, Justin Lapate and his colleague founded the original American Society of Regional Anesthesia. And it was changed after that to regional anesthesia and pain medicine. Now, this one of our journal during this time, current research in anesthesia and analgesia. Actually, it is the same of anesthesia and analgesia, but from August 1922 till December 1956, it was current research in anesthesia and analgesia. After that, it is anesthesia and analgesia, and you can see the price is only 50 cents, and subscription for the whole year is $3. And the editorial letter of this issue in December 1922 about the improper payment for the anesthesiologist, which is still a problem in some countries, says the insurance companies not paying well for the anesthesiologist, and they consider anesthesia something minor for the operative procedure. That's why many doctors are not attractive to go for anesthesia practice. But this, of course, is improved with the time. We have some articles about the nitrous oxide. Actually, nitrous oxide is used long time ago in anesthesia, maybe from 1844, but its development and the practice in anesthesia only in early 19th. And another article about the present status of local anesthesia or sacral anesthesia in anorectal disease. You may ask, what is sacral anesthesia? Actually, it is caudal. But the name during this time, it is the sacral anesthesia. And it was first used in 1901 in Paris, but after that in 1909, it was used in Germany for obstetric anesthesia, and with the time it is used for obstetric anesthesia in rectal surgery and for lower limb surgery as well. One of the interested articles in December 1922 about the breath holding test as a safety first factor in determining the surgical risk and oxygen need under anesthesia. You may notice that the title of the article a little bit strange. The language is not common for us. But anyway, they have some tests to see the fitness of patient during pre-operative assessment. So again, you may ask, what is the breath holding test? The breath holding test is you take a deep breathing and try to hold it for 60 seconds. If you are able to hold it for 10 seconds only, this means it is very sick patient and is critically ill, and usually this patient in the hospital. If the patient hold it for 10 to 20 seconds, it is a sick patient. 20 to 40, poor health. From 40 to 60 seconds, it is good health. More than 60, it is ideal health. Actually, despite it is very old test, but still working until now. It is a nice test. One of the article, I will describe it in details, but later on, the management of patient under nitrous oxide, oxygen anesthesia for open mouth work and by secondary saturation. So I will leave you for a time to think what is the open work, open mouth work, and what is secondary saturation mean. Another article about some case of unusual interest to the anesthetist, some case reports, and it is three or four case reports. I will discuss only one of them, and it is named the status lymphaticus. Of course, everybody shocked now. What is this status lymphaticus? We hear about status asthmaticus, status epilepticus, but status lymphaticus, what is this? You will see now. The history of this baby, 7 months old, and he is suffering from cleft lip. And the anesthesia was into induction by anesthesia by chloroform through a Janger mask. And when the patient has deep anesthesia or surgical anesthesia, they change this chloroform to ether after that. So induction with chloroform and maintenance with ether. And you may ask, what is Janker mask? This is Janker mask or chloroform mask, which is introduced to the clinical anesthesia practice in 1865. So what happened after that, after 5 or 10 minutes and use of ether, the patient start to be pale and the breathing is very shallow and the pupil is dilated and the patient has complete muscle relaxation. If you think myself, I think this is severely hypoxic for a long time, not just for a short time. But it is not explained. That's why I copy and paste the articles to see the scientific language during this time. Again, it is great difference between us now, maybe 98 years and in 1922. Anyway, after 5 to 10 minutes, the patient start to PPL, shallow breathing and dilated pupils. And they stopped all the anesthesia, and something very strange, I didn't find any reference for that. Face is rubbed with a cloth. What is the action, stimulation, what will happen? Actually, I didn't understand it, despite I searched a lot. Anyway, after face is rubbed with a cloth, the patient start to breathe, and he started to recover initially after that, and he is able to open and close his eyes, and the color of the skin is better. But after 1 hour, the respiration is still regular, and notice that no more breathing. After a while, the color becomes pale and the pupil dilated again. So the patient has some incident, they stopped the ether, and after that, the same incident happened again. What happened, we don't know. And despite of the everything can be done, artificial breathing, giving oxygen, this is something important at the moment. They are not using oxygen routine in all patients. That's why ether is given in a mixture of air, not with oxygen. That's why I explained it by severe hypoxemia. And heart massage or cardiac massage through the chest wall, the child failed to respond and there is no more time for this patient. So what is the explanation of the authors who present this case? It seems likely that this patient has one of these cases of status lymphaticus which are likely to die during anesthesia. Again, we can't explain what is that. So what is the status lymphaticus? It is all the term, and suppose that there is some enlargement of the thymus and lymph nodes can happen in infants and young children as well. And it was believed that can be associated with sudden death. Especially under anesthesia, it may cause sudden enlargement of the thymus, which will compress the trachea and may cause death. This actually happened with actually two investigators from UK found that this is a heap of rubbish. There is nothing named status lymphaticus, and it is a type of medical mythology. So there is nothing named status lymphaticus, and it looks that the patient is severely hypoxic. Of course, there is no monitoring this time. He didn't mention about the blood pressure monitoring or the pulse monitoring, just he mentioned the breathing and the change of the color and the response of the pupils. Anyway, there is nothing named status lymphaticus. We will come back, how is the world in 1922? The tomb of Tutankhamun was discovered by Howard Carter in Luxor in Egypt. And also the Disney, Walt Disney incorporated his first film company. And this Ford truck from 1922 and the very nice BMW as well in 1922. We come back to our anesthesia. This is the case. I will explain it in 4 or 5 minutes. Management of patient under nitrous oxide oxygen for open mouth work by secondary saturation. Two strange expression here, the open mouth work. What do you think? Actually, it is the dental surgery. What is the secondary saturation? You will find what is the mean of secondary saturation now. So this is the dental chair. So we are talking about a patient coming for dental surgery and is using the nitrous oxide for this type of operation to induce and quiet smooth anesthesia, which is desirable. So relaxation is the secondary saturation. How they are doing is that just start to induce anesthesia by the nitrous oxide until the patient is anesthetized and sleeping. And they give more dose, very high dose of the nitrous oxide until the patient will be relaxed, and you will see now what is the signs of this secondary saturation after giving nitrous to the patient. First, you have to prepare yourself with good, this safety of anesthesia. Prepare your equipment, prepare your assistant, and you prepare your machine. So the safety of anesthesia, a concept since long time about the proper preparation of yourself. Something a little bit strange, these operations are done in clinic or in office, not in the hospital. So maybe nitrous oxide is common in dental practice, but this technique is extremely dangerous, as you will see now, to be done in office or in the clinic. So the patient, as usual, come fasting, as usual, and in upright position, patient sitting in the dental chair, and they are giving him nasal inhaler and something in the mouth to prevent biting, like airway or to something used by the dental surgeon to prevent biting during the surgery. So they introduce the anesthesia by nitrous oxide through the nasal inhaler. So patient is giving straight nitrous oxide until signs of anesthesia appear. I think straight nitrous oxide means nitrous oxide in air without oxygen. So because as you see now, he makes oxygen at some stage, not all the stages of the anesthesia. And until the patient come very deep, the patient, that point of saturation, how to go to it, increase the flow of nitrous oxide to go to this secondary saturation by increasing the amount of oxygen flow. So, assuming that this patient is already relaxed, so he reached the secondary saturation and the surgeons can work during this time on the patient. But how to know the signs of these secondary saturations? Actually, as mentioned, all signs of overdose of the nitric oxide as described by Mark Kisson. We will see Mark Kisson how described for us this overdose. First, for respiration, irregular breathing, patient may have prolonged expiration, spasm of the vocal cord, and cessation of respiration. So the patient irregular breathing, spasm, and cessation of respiratory patients is apneic. Next one, the muscular phenomena. The patient has colonic movement, seizure, expiration while looking. It is a little bit strange medical term, but this is it is written in these articles. And the patient has vomiting, tetanic spasm, and the marked rigidity. So patient has colonic movement, seizure or convulsions, vomiting, and tetanic spasm. This is a good sign for him for relaxation. Then the eye is dilated and unreactive and irregular in shape. Conjunctiva is insensitive. Eyeball is fixed and the eyelids is fixed as well. So we have a patient with all these signs to operate on by the dental surgeons. Still, the color of the skin usually cyanotic, and the patient, if anemic, cyanosis, of course, will not appear, but if the patient is pleuritic, he will be black. And you will see there is no signs of cardiovascular signs. This means the patient is apneic, pupil dilated, unreactive, spasm, vomiting, and this is a good sign to operate on. So this is the stage of relaxation of our patient, and according to the writer or the author of this article, it is very easy to operate in this patient, severely hypoxemic, severely cyanotic, so it is a good situation to work in. The strange comment by the authors, it is great satisfaction to ourselves and for our patient as well, and they can work the, as you can see, this is open the mouth surgery, impacted teeth and alveolectomy or any other dental surgery during this time. So the conclusion of these authors, that noisy or difficult patients can be operated on the dental chair by nitrous oxide, oxygen without any other medication. Secondary saturation is agreeable and certain method of attaining relaxations. And the last thing, the training of surgical team for major operation in the mouth is recommended. Actually, I don't know why he added this third conclusion. It is something related to the surgery, why he included it in anesthesia, but maybe to instruction for the surgeon to work in a short time under this risky situation. So in conclusion of this one, the general anesthesia during this time, they are using usually one drug. This is like nitrous oxide or ether to use the triad of anesthesia or the amnesia, analgesia, or muscle relaxation. But maybe after more than 20 years, Cecil Gray and John Halters introduced the concept of balanced anesthesia. I think everybody aware about Cecil Gray. He is very famous since textbook since long time. And he published what is named the Liverpool Triad or Liverpool Technique. So what is the Liverpool Triad? What do you think? I think it is Salah, Mani, and Firmino. Actually, it is not like that. According to the Cecil Gray, it is narcosis, analgesia, and muscle relaxation. And thank you, sir, very much for your attention. Hope you enjoyed it.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Yasser. Well, very, very interesting lectures and subjects. And I think I'll take from your lecture the status lymphaticus for the residents to fail down, inshallah.